So there's no clear definition of for co-living concepts, but what they all have in common is the focus on the community. So these concepts, they want to create a sense of community by having public spaces such as co-working areas, rooftop lounges, and sometimes small cinemas or food and beverage outlets. And then in most cases also moderated by a community manager who also organizes events, all kind of events such as cooking classes, barbecue parties, panel discussions. These events are sometimes also organized by the tenants themselves. So the community is clearly in the center of co-living concepts. And then you have, of course, also single studios or small apartments, ideally equipped with a kitchenette and a bathroom. Currently, the typical target group are millennials, Generation Z, but we also see more and more in the future the multi-generational co-living concepts that don't exist as such yet. And if we speak about multi-generational, we also speak about senior residents. We also speak about life changers who experience just a change in their life. For example, they got relocated to another country. They just got divorced, single parents. We see still a lot of potential for these co-living concepts in the future. But as mentioned at the moment, Generation Z and Generation Y are clearly the target group, the main target group. So one major USP of co-living concepts is the convenience. If I may take myself as an example, before I moved to Vienna, I lived in Dubai and I had to arrange an apartment for myself from far away. And the way how I did it was just using my mobile phone. And then I took my two suitcases and arrived in Vienna in a fully furnished apartment with a kitchenette, with a bathroom, with Wi-Fi, everything was already there. And if you compare this to the traditional search for housing, especially in bigger cities, and then ideally still centrally located, it's a huge challenge in general. But for this co-living, with the co-living concept, it was not a challenge at all. So convenience is one USP for sure. And then on the other hand, if you arrive in a new city where you don't know anybody, co-living concepts give you the opportunity to meet new people right away. You have the community manager, as mentioned earlier, who's organizing events. So you are living by yourself on your own, but at the same time, you're not alone if you want to meet new people and engage with others. I see a positive outlook for co-living concepts because in the end, these concepts, they just respond to a change in lifestyle. People, especially millennials and the Generation Z, they want to be more flexible. They want to move from place to place. And these concepts, they give you this opportunity and this freedom. We also see, of course, a shift to home office that has been also accelerated this process due to COVID-19. And if you have the opportunity to work from home, there's no reason why you should work from Vienna, let's say, if you can also work for 3 months from Barcelona, as an example. So also to this trend, these concepts are responding. In general, we also see a trend towards shared economy. So nowadays we share our bikes, we share our e-scooters, we share our cars, we share everything. And we also slowly start to share our living spaces, public areas. And if we see Vienna, for example, we have currently around 45% of all households, single households, and this is expected to increase. Also for this specific target group, co-living concepts are appealing because these people, they are living on their own, but at the same time, they are not living on their own and nobody wants to be isolated. And if we speak from our clients' perspective, we at PKF, we see more and more projects coming related to co-living concepts, also serviced apartments. More and more investors are interested. And that's why we see a clear trend and a positive outlook for these concepts in general.